This is Brent of the Brookbush Institute, and we're going over manual release of the gastroc and soleus complex. Keep in mind, this is a video for educational purposes, and I'm assuming that if you're watching this video to learn this technique, you are a licensed manual practitioner, and you are going to pay attention to the laws on scope of practice in your state. Sorry, personal trainers, this video doesn't fall within your scope. I'm going to have Brian come out. He's going to help me demonstrate this technique. Now, you can assume that if I'm going to release the gastroc and soleus complex, I have already done a set of assessments that have given me an indication that he either lacks extensibility or is showing signs of overactivity in his gastroc and soleus complex. That could be things like the overhead squat assessment, where feet flat, feet turn out, or an excessive forward lean may all indicate overactivity here. It might have just been something as simple as a dorsiflexion goniometry. I see a lack of dorsiflexion. These two muscles could restrict that. I could have done my gastroc soleus muscle length test, and that could have given me an indication that there was some overactivity here. Now, once we have determined that this is an area we want to palpate and look for further signs of overactivity, it is helpful to know your trigger points. All right, so your common trigger points are very much related to motor points, which is where we have the neuromuscular junction innervating the muscle, and this is often a site of dysfunction within these overactive muscles. Right, so you can see here I've gone ahead and put circles where the common soleus trigger points are, and then X is where the common gastroc trigger points are. It is helpful for me to kind of know roundabout where those are, but I'm going to show you guys how to find them even if you didn't have them all memorized. What I generally do is I take one of the pads of my thumb and I start kind of strumming perpendicular to the fascicles, kind of like I'd be rubbing over guitar strings. Another little hint here, guys, is if you use your thigh to press into dorsiflexion a little bit, that helps put some tension, helps lengthen out this muscle, it'll help pop those fascicles into your finger. All right, so I can see here's a tight fascicle. Now what I want to do is I want to go proximal and distal to see if what's causing the tightness in that fascicle is actually a nodule or a specific location of a trigger point. And so I can start doing my strumming kind of up and down, and I seem to be getting cold there, warmer. All right, right there. That's a nice spot. So once I found that spot, to help me pin that spot down so that it doesn't end up feeling like I'm trying to put my finger on a marble, right, where it just kind of keeps popping out, I want to go ahead and put a little bit more tension by pressing them into dorsiflexion. Actually, let me have you move down just a little bit, Brian, so I don't... Be careful, guys, as you push somebody into dorsiflexion, you don't want to push the front of their ankle into the end of the table. That's painful. All right, so find that little spot again. I'm going to make sure I put a little stretch in that muscle that's going to help pull everything down, help centralize that trigger point. And then I'm actually going to use a little distal to proximal force with my thumb here to kind of pin it up this way. So rather than trying to do this, I'm putting a little stretch and pinning up this way. And then to add a little bit more pressure, I'm actually going to go ahead and let this be my dummy thumb. So I'm not using this hand to apply pressure, I'm going to use this hand to apply pressure. The amount of pressure I apply is actually going to be up to, I wouldn't say the first resistance barrier, but the first significant increase in resistance from his tissue. I think you guys will find that as you press into tissue, it's almost like an exponential curve, right? You have this nice linear increase in how much pressure you get back, and then all of a sudden it's like this really, really big increase in tension. So I'm going to press right up into that trough of that curve till I got a significant resistance, but not past it. And then all I have to do is use my body weight, nice straight arms, nice good posture, and hold it until that point starts to go away. And then if I have time, I can start moving through some other trigger points that may exist in this muscle. All right, guys, so going through this whole technique again, I went ahead and put just a little bit of pressure into Brian's foot here. That's going to help dorsiflex his ankle, put a little bit of tension into this system, lengthen those fibers out so that they're going to pop into my fingers a little bit. I then run my thumb across the fascicles of the gastroc or the soleus in this case. All right, I'm going to look for the most tender fascicles. Once I find those tighter, denser fascicles, I'm going to move proximal and distal, and I find like that's a pretty good spot right there. Once I have a spot, I'm going to go ahead and kind of go up this way with the pressure on the gastroc and soleus, put a little bit more pressure into his foot, so I dorsiflex him a little bit more. I'm going to use the opposite hand to press right up to that resistance barrier, and then I'm going to hold that until that goes away. There is one other protocol with 4 6-to-8-second holds. If you guys prefer that protocol, you can do that too. So I could sit here, hold 2 3 4 5 6, relax, go back in, maybe a little deeper into the tissue this time. 1 2 3 4 5 6. If not, if I'm going back to just that static hold, then it's usually a 20 to 30 second static hold. After I've done that release technique, in Brian's case, I'd probably go ahead and flip him back over, do some joint mobilizations if I thought maybe his talus was shifted anteriorly or whatever other joint mobilizations I needed to do in his ankle complex, and then follow that up with a lengthening technique if I thought these muscles were short. So I wouldn't use release techniques alone, but this would certainly be the first step in me helping to regain some ankle mobility and calm down any overactivity in the gastroc and soleus complex. Just to go over quickly, guys, in a more close-up view so you can see exactly what it is I'm doing. Notice I have my thigh, the bottom of Brian's foot here, so I can control dorsiflexion and plantar flexion and the amount of tension in the system. I can use this thumb to kind of dig into about midway through the gastroc there, just into the first signs of tissue resistance, and I can kind of move across the fascicles perpendicular to them and kind of strum to find the most dense or the highest activity in those fascicles. We're going to assume that those increased activity in those fascicles is a sign of this overactivity and dysfunction. Once I get there, I'm going to go ahead and move proximal, distal, and actually I can feel it. There's not as much tissue density, not as much give back resistance here as there is here, so I know I'm getting closer, and then right about here I actually do feel a nice tight nodule. Now, I kind of mentioned to you guys before, it's a little hard to pin down if you just kind of go thumb over thumb on top. It's also very, very painful to do it this way. It might help be a little bit more helpful to go a little bit more broad with your finger. Use this as your dummy thumb, so now no more pressure in this hand. I'm going to go ahead and push into dorsiflexion just a little bit so I feel that trigger point come into my thumb, and then I'm going to use my other hand to press until I feel that big increase in tissue resistance. As I kind of mentioned, I think of an exponential curve, right? And if it's an exponential curve that I feel resistance, I want to be right in the trough. All right, so I'm going to go right here again. And I'm going to go ahead and hold that for 30 seconds. Or as I mentioned earlier in this video, we could do 4 8-second holds. I think this feels pretty good though. I should get a release here. Brian is starting to feel it let go a little bit. Yeah, usually it's a very tender spot at first, and then within a few seconds everything calms down. So there you guys have it. Manual release of the gastroc and soleus complex. Grab a partner, grab a colleague, get to practicing. This is probably not something you want to do to the next patient that walks in the door if you've never done it before. The gastroc and soleus do tend to be very tender muscles when it comes to compression and manual release techniques. I would definitely get another manual therapist with experience in these techniques if you can. Getting the feedback from another manual therapist is education that cannot be replaced. If nothing else, get a group of you guys together so you can start talking about whose pressures felt the best or whose hands felt the best and what you guys are doing to help dial this technique in. I hope you learned from this video. I hope you will integrate this technique into your manual practices. I look forward to hearing about what type of outcomes you get by adding this to your repertoire.